Hello students, so today we will see one more machine dependent assembly feature, which is program relocation. Okay, so we all know that any program that needs to be executed should be loaded onto the main memory. Okay, so we know that several programs can be executing in the main memory at a point of time, which is called as multi-programming. Sure. Okay, so these programs will be having some address, starting address that is assigned to it, right? That is called as absolute address. So sometimes if a program here in the example cannot be loaded onto the memory specified in the starting address. See, for example, this particular program starts at address 1000, which is the absolute address. But then in the main memory, there is no place at 1000. We will have to relocate this program to some other location wherein there is space. Okay, so this is called as program relocation. So let's assume that there is a program given here which has 1000 as its starting address, but then in the main memory there is no place at 1000 address. So this program must be relocated to some other free space. This is called as program relocation. So load programs into memory whenever there is a room, not specifying a fixed address at an assembly time. That is, you can't always put a particular program onto its mentioned starting address. You'll have to find if that place is free or not in the main memory. In case it is not free, then you'll obviously have to relocate the program to some other location. So this process is called as program relocation. So here an example is taken with respect to SIC architecture. You know that in SIC architecture, here in this portion, we will directly take the address of the operand that is mentioned. Okay, that is, suppose let's say that the label 3 was at address 102D, then we take it directly here. Okay, and let's assume that there is no place at address 1000 in the main memory, but there is place starting at 2000. So this particular program has to be loaded at 2000 location. So in that case, what changes that needs to be done to the assembly code is, definitely this particular part will change because we have directly taken the address in the object code, right? So since this program has been relocated at a location 2000 in the main memory, you'll have to add 2000 directly to the mentioned direct address. That is, 1002D should be added to 2000, which gives you a value 2002D. Okay, this means that every absolute address, that is every direct address, should be modified. So this is an example of SIC. This is how you do the program relocation. That is, whichever addresses are taken directly, that should be added to the new starting address in order to obtain the address at the main memory. So now we'll see an example with respect to SIC-XC. So in SIC-XC, you very well know that there are format 4 instructions, right? Okay, so let's assume that we have been given an address that starts at 1000. Okay, this is an object code, or this is currently not in main memory. Okay, and it starts at 1000. This is an absolute address. So 1000, and there is an instruction plus JSUB RDREC. You very well know that we allocate 20 bits, which is 5 hexa. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, till here. That is 01036 is the direct address of RDREC. So let's say this program is now loaded onto the main memory, and at 000 location, there is no free space. So this has to be moved to a location 5000. That is program relocation. So there are some addresses that need to be modified, right? So definitely starting from this, that is here 0000 will now become 5000, and for every other addresses you need to add 5000 in order to get that corresponding address. Now look at this, 4B will still remain the same because this is the opcode and one is with respect to the flags, and 01036 is the direct address of RDREC. So this is also direct address, right? So this also needs to be modified. So in this case, you'll have to modify this by adding 5000 to 01036, which gives you 06036. Okay, and B410 does not change because this was a format 2 instruction with respect to register. So there is no change. As I mentioned, you have to change only the direct addresses. Okay, so let's consider again the program is relocated to another free space in the main memory that starts at 7420. So similarly, so now if you try to subtract 5000 from 7420, you get 2420, right? Okay, so you will have to add 2420 to each of the direct addresses. So if you try adding 2420 to 06036, you get it as 08456. So this is called as changing or modifying direct addresses. Fine. Okay. So here, so this is called as relocatable program. Program loading starting address is determined at the load time, because at the load time itself, you get to know whether the same address can be assigned in the main memory or it has to be relocated or not. Okay, so you should make a program such that it can be relocated to any point in the main memory. So an object program, you know what an object program is, right? The object program that consists of the header, text and end record. So that is object program. And an object program that contains the information necessary to perform address modification. That is, now apart from header record, text record and end record, you need to now add extra information for the loader to know what should be changed or which location it has to load the particular program to. Okay, so extra information should be provided in the object program. So the assembler must identify for the loader those parts of the object program that need modification. Okay, now no instruction modification is needed for immediate addressing or PC relative addressing. As I mentioned, you only need to change the place where there are direct addresses. Apart from that, don't make any changes to the instructions that involve PC relative or immediate addressing. Here, it is not to be changed. See, for example, you know that PC addressing is nothing but, how do you find displacement? Displacement is nothing but target address minus PC, right? Yeah. So let's say target address is 2000, fine. And PC is, 1000. Clear. What is the difference between the two? It is 1000, right? Yeah, it is going to remain 1000. Suppose you try to change the location during the process of relocation. So let's say target address is now 3000. Then the program counter is going to be 1000 more, right? So it's going to be 2000. Right, so if you again subtract 2000 from 3000, it is still going to be 1000. So there is no change in the subtraction. Only the values of the DA or the PC have increased, but then the subtraction value still remains the same. So whenever you have immediate addressing, you know what is immediate addressing. The value that is mentioned in hash itself is to be written in the object code, right? So you don't have to modify that. Neither you have to modify PC relative or base relative addressing. Apart from that, all the addresses which involve direct addresses should be modified. That is, the only parts of the program that require modification at load time are those that specify direct addresses. And in SICXE, only the extended format instructions, that is format 4, needs this modification. Apart from that, format 2 and format 3 don't require modifications. Okay, so as I said, if you take SICXE, 1, 2, 3 need not be modified. Format 4 should be modified. The only reason is in the object code, in the target address field, which is 20 bits, you directly take the address of the operand. So definitely it is going to change, no? So that should be modified. And in SIC, everything should be modified because the address of the operand itself is taken as the target address, if you remember. Okay, so these are the things that you need to modify in SICXE and SIC. So as I said, we need to pass on some information to the loader in order to modify. Okay, so we call that record as modification record, and along with the H record and text record and end record, we add one more record, which is modification record. In modification records, we have three details. Okay, So one is M, which indicates it's a modification record. And the second detail is, see, for example, let's say at place, in the previous example, just go through the previous example, just go here. Yeah, see here. Yeah, look at this. So you had to change here, right? This one, right? So if you start counting from the relative address, that is the first point. So this is first. So if you start counting, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the seventh location, though it is 006 because it has started from 0000, but then it is the seventh location. So you will have to modify it seventh location. Okay. Okay. So let's move on to that particular slide. Okay. Yes, in this case, so as I said, you will have to move to the seventh location. If you start counting from the first, okay, so this is at the seventh location. So that is the beginning address of the program is added to the field. So look at this. In column 2 and 7, you have to mention the starting location of the address field to be modified relative to the beginning of the program. So relative to the beginning of the program, it is 7. Okay, now how many bits have to be modified? For example, in plus JSIP, so we know that 20 bits are there in the address field, right? Okay, so in this, how many places you fill? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so you just need to change the 5 bits of the address. That is, these 5 bits of the address field in format 4 should be changed. So this is what is the modification record. It consists of 3 fields. One is modification field, followed by the location where you want to change and how many bits you want to change. That is how many places. It is 5 places. So this is in half bytes. Okay. So half bytes. So what is half byte? 1 byte is 8, right? So in that case, half byte is 4. So 4 into this 5 gives you 20. Okay. So this is what it means, that 5 places needs to be modified. This is the information that we need to pass by the assembler to the loader whenever it does not find the exact location to load the program onto the main memory. So definitely it has to relocate the program to some other free place available in the main memory. Thank you.